Hi, it's Jan Beta, and today I want to try to resurrect some really severely scratched optical media, in particular these PlayStation 2 games that I got donated by Thomas recently. And these are scratched to an extent where they no longer work in my PlayStation 2, so they are really badly damaged. And I'm going to try to polish the DVD surfaces to an extent where they actually start working again, hopefully. First time I ever tried this, and I did some research and came up with a method that probably works. Let's find out. I got my PlayStation 2 set up here, and I'm just going to demonstrate how dysfunctional this Tiger Woods PGA Tour 2008 game is. It should technically boot up after I insert it. And it seems to try to read it. And it continues to try to read it. And now it at least got the PlayStation 2 logo. But there's not much going on after that. So this is completely non-working as far as I can see. I tried this a couple of times, tried to clean the surface of the DVD, but to no avail. Yeah, and as you can see, we got some pretty severe scratches on the surface here. I don't know how well it's visible on camera, but if I angle it slightly, you can probably see some pretty bad scratches there. And that's, of course, the surface. The laser tries to read the actual data, which is on this aluminum layer that you can see through the translucent layer. This should be polycarbonate, so it's a really hard plastic layer. And then there is a very fine layer of aluminum that has the actual data on it. And then there's another layer of plastic on top here. And the theory is that we can just polish these scratches away from this surface, and the laser is going to be able to focus again on the data layer. On DVDs, this polycarbonate layer is very thin. I think from my research, it is a bit thinner than on CDs, which have equal amounts of polycarbonate on both sides. The layer on DVDs is actually thinner than on CDs, it seems. Either way, we only have a very thin layer to work with, so we don't want to take too much material away from this. So what I'm going to try to do is to use some very fine grit sandpaper. This is a 2000 grit and this is a 3000 grit. So these are on the finer side of sandpapers. I'm going to start with the more coarse sandpaper and then go to this finer one, and then I'm going to finish it with this polishing paste, which is meant to be used on like car headlights and things like that. It's a general acrylic and plexiglass polishing paste that I got for cheap. So yeah, I hope this works. I've never tried this before. Your mileage may vary depending on how severe your scratches are. So you might have to start with a finer grit sandpaper or just go to the polishing paste right away. I'm going to use a wet sanding approach. This is actually sandpaper that's usable both dry and wet. I'm going to put some water on here and then try to polish out the scratches. That's basically all this is about, and I'm going to see if this works. Yeah, you might say this is a bit modern for this channel, but this is something that I really want to try because I never actually tried it, as I said. And I think there is a good chance we can make these old optical media work again. So that would be amazing. Some people recommend using toothpaste for the polishing step. I'm not too sure about that because toothpaste varies quite a bit. There are some abrasive, like little abrasive bits in there. But I think the granularity of those and the size of those varies quite a bit across different brands and different kinds of toothpaste probably. So yeah, you can try that. I've even seen a YouTube video where somebody just put toothpaste all over a DVD and just let it soak for a while and then it magically worked again. But yeah, that clearly doesn't work. You have to do some polishing. So we're going to do that. I'm going to put on some gloves because this stuff says you have to wear gloves. Because it seems to be pretty aggressive. I hope it's not too aggressive against the plastic. But this stuff is just sandpaper, so this is non-toxic probably. Yeah, let's try. So the first step obviously is to clean this. So I'm just going to use some water. And you can just clean these in this sink with some dish soap, but yeah, we don't want anything on there that would potentially make the scratches worse. And I'm using distilled water here just because I can. You can of course use tap water. And I'm just going to go with the 2000 grit sandpaper. And I'm going to wipe down some of the surface here. I'm doing circular movements because I think it helps to get this more evenly polished in the end. And obviously we're adding scratches at this point, so yeah. There's nothing much to lose, I guess, because this was severely broken before. And you want to polish it to a point where all the original scratches disappear. Now, of course, it's completely scratched. Just using some very light pressure here. And it looks pretty even already. This, of course, looks much worse than before because we took away the surface and roughed it up quite significantly. So now we're going to the 3000 grit sandpaper and we're going to repeat the step. And of course, you can't repair discs that have the actual data layer damaged. That's not fixable by a human, I guess. Don't know about you, but I'm thinking about the polishing a turd Mythbusters episode all the time. Did I say turd? Sorry. Now for the final step, I'm putting some of this polishing paste on there. This is just a kitchen towel, so let's see. Wow, it smells bad. It smells pretty bad. No wonder nobody should touch this stuff. And now we just let it soak for a while and it's going to magically repair itself. No, this is not one of those videos. Yeah, and we should be able to get this to a mirror finish, but it's going to take some time. So I went on to use a significantly softer cloth here, which is just, I think, cotton. It's a piece of old clothing that I cut up. And this seems to do the trick better. Of course, you could use a dedicated polishing sponge or something like that, which would be even better probably. And I'm continuously adding some water. And I also put my fan in place here so we have some ventilation, because frankly this stuff smells quite horrible. Hey, and after a significant amount of more polishing, your mileage may vary there, of course. I think I got it to work. It takes a long time to load, but that might just be normal for this game. But it's actually reading and the noise is not too bad actually. Just some error correction too, so we might have to do some more polishing. Hey, but it's loading! Yay! And it's checking for a memory card and EA Sports. It's in the game. Yeah, there we go. Hope I don't get flagged for the music. That's actually music. Hey, but it's loading now. There we go. It works again. It's not going to be my favorite game, probably. And I sent the balls somewhere. But hey, this proves that the method does work. Yeah, this is what we ended up with. There's still some minor scratches. I don't even know if they are visible at all to you, but I can still see some minor scratches there. And yeah, we could go on polishing this for a while and they would disappear probably and would be as good as new. So I might even do that. But yeah, I think I proved my point here. This is a totally reasonable way to resurrect your optical media. Yeah, I'm probably going to try the other DVD off camera because the process takes some time. I polished this for, I don't know, half an hour or something. It was quite a pain. My hand is a bit hurting. But yeah, it works. It totally works. You can, at least if you don't have significant scratches that go into the actual data layer, you can refinish DVDs to make them work again with this method. Yeah, that's it for today. I hope you found this informative. Hope it helps you maybe bring some of your optical media back to life. Tiger Woods talking there in the background. Yeah. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks to everybody who supports me on Patreon or on the YouTube channel memberships page. Hope you stay safe. Hope to see you again on this channel. I'm Jan Beta. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye. Yeah, now to try how this actually works. Oh, that wasn't too bad. You're the tiger. The eye of the tiger. Yay, bogey!